don't work another day earning money until you get a subscription to Bob Chapman's publication. Matter of fact, Midas Resources, the sister parent company or whatever to GCN, so believes in what Bob's telling you that they're willing to give a free year subscription to anybody who buys a gold 20-franc coin. You can take advantage of that at 1-800-686-2237. You can also contact Bob's organization at 877-479-8178. Now, before the break, we were talking about the debacle that we call Europe, the plague that is the European Union. We talked earlier last week about how 81% of Israelis are in favor of joining the European Union. If you're in Israel listening to this show, stop. Don't do it. Oppose this thing. This is a cyst. I'm telling you, it'll just destroy your economy. Now, with this segment, I want to get back to what's going on in America. There is a term called hyperinflation. A lot of people know what inflation is, Mr. Chapman, but a lot of people don't understand what hyperinflation is. Can you tell us what hyperinflation is and what life would look like if that happens?
Well, inflation is caused by central banks creating money and credit beyond the revenues that are coming in the form of taxes. And usually what that does is creates inflation. Now, I'll give you a good example, and then I'll get to hyperinflation. Inflation right now is 10.6%. Government says it's 3.6% or 3.2%, whatever it is, which is not within the realm of reality because government lies all the time about everything. And they have a new formula they're going to try to put forth here shortly, which is part of this debt extension package, where they'll reconfigure the cost of living, if you may, inflation, the CPI, as it's called. And what's happening is that the Fed is creating money and credit, and it's forcing, and this is several ways they can do it, it's forcing inflation higher. I predicted over a year ago inflation would be 14% this year. It's probably conservative. And next year, with QE2 and Stimulus 2, the results thereof, they will probably see 25 to 30%. And if they have a QE3 and the numbers are comparable to 1 and 2, then they can get up to 50%. So when you get to 50% and beyond, it's hyperinflation. And that's why I gave you the example. And I expect that to happen, because they can't continue to make the system work without creating money and credit. Right. Because what they've done is they've really just destroyed the system. And the only way they can keep it going on an even keel or sideways or slightly down is by creating this money and credit. And that's why we have to have QE3. Otherwise, the system will be purged with deflationary depression like we saw in the 1930s, which was preceded by the same general scenario between 1923 and 1930. And so, and I use 30 because the market fell apart in September
right.
of 1929 and October. So it was really, the gear was gone. And so that's where we end up. That's what hyperinflation is. And it's a result of inflation going bonkers. And it's caused by central banks. And the outcome is usually, like we saw in Weimar in Germany in 1923, a hyperinflationary collapse and the evolution into deflationary depression. And that was a condition we in Europe never got out of. Europe had its national socialist governments of one form or another. And we had a democratic government, but none of the nations could recover. And so what did they do? They had another war.
Well, if that is the case, and if hyperinflation is on its way here, most Americans delude themselves so much with television and entertainment and just, you know, work, they don't have time to really get into this or believe it. What would life look like at hyperinflation? Would we be, you know, wheeling barrels of money to the grocery store to get bread, or is this all back end on paper only? It only affects the big banks and it doesn't really affect the individual.
It certainly affects everybody. Whether you'd use a wheelbarrow or not remains to be seen. In the condition that banks are in today in America, most of them are bankrupt. And so, in fact, they're using two sets of books. You go and do that, you end up in jail. And so, yes, that could happen. But what would happen, I think, in America would be very similar to what happened in Germany or in Zimbabwe recently. And that's one of the places I lived as well. And what would happen would be you'd get your wages or your salary, and you go to the bank and cash your check and get cash and leap out there and buy food and clothing and the things that you need to pay your bills before the money was devalued the following hour or the following day or the following week. So it's a race to use a currency. And in Weimar, what they did was they first were printing 1,000 and then 5,000 and 10,000 mark notes. It got so bad that they would only print one side, and they take them and reprint the other side with a higher number. And so that can happen in America. America's not immune to anything. I mean, this is a human condition, unfortunately created deliberately to bring people in the United States, England, and Europe to their knees financially and economically so that they can enforce world government upon them.
Well, and it's important to note that when this happens, it's not like a hurricane where you see it for some time. You know, before this happens, you said moments ago that it can happen in days and weeks. You'll wake up one morning and all of a sudden your entire financial understanding of your economy is upside down.
That's right, and people don't understand that. Why don't they understand it? Because they never studied it. Nobody's ever told them. Study. I've talked to thousands of people who have business degrees, MBAs, and PhDs. They don't have a clue to what I'm talking about.
Well, that's why it's
so
important.
They don't even know that there was a Weimar Republic and the economy collapsed in the evolutionary process of the late 1950s, brought the National Socialist Party into being, which in turn became the vehicle for Adolf Hitler. And the same thing can happen in America.
Well, you know, it's funny that you bring up World War II, because the more I do research, the more I find out that the same financiers were backing both sides of the war, so they won no matter what. And the
Absolutely.
Only people who were at risk
and
were the
in
people.
In fact, what got me onto this whole thing was in 1955, when in counterintelligence, I was given a book called The War in Ether, War Over the Airwaves. And one of the things that I did was I was involved in electronic spying. And the Japanese diplomatic code had been broken both by the British and the Americans in 1937. So they knew everything the Japanese were doing. So when they were ready for the war, they lined the ships up in Pearl Harbor and just waited for them to come in and bomb them so they can get in the war.
And wait
a second.
I found
that to be dastardly. I mean, I had been brought up like every other American during the 1930s and 40s to believe that we didn't do those kind of things. Well, I get news for you. We've been doing it for a long time, long before that.
Wow. Wow. Okay, so we have one more segment left. You just shook me, because I knew we financed Germany, but I didn't know we had it worked out and in cahoots with the Japanese either. So that just... Wow. You're listening to The Josh Tolley Show. We have Bob Chapman. We'll be back right after this.